Hey, how's it going everybody? It's your bro here, hope you're doing well, and in this video I'm going to teach you guys how we can create and customize our own check buttons in Python, so sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Alright my fellow bros, in this video we're going to be creating and customizing our own check buttons in Python. I sometimes refer to these as checkboxes, so in case I do, that's what I'm referring to. As always, we'll need a window, window equals tk followed by window.mainloop, and let's call this button just check button. And in order to create this check button, we type in the name of the check button equals check button. And within the constructor, what are we adding this check button to? We're adding this to our window. And also within the constructor, we can set the different options for how we want to customize this check button. Let's begin with the text. Text equals I agree to something. And last but not least, we need to add this check button to the window. One way in which we can do that is to use the pack function of this widget. So follow this with checkbutton.pack. When we run this, we have our check button within our window and we can toggle this on or off. Right now I'm agreeing to something. I'm not sure what I'm agreeing to, but hopefully it's not anything bad. Now currently this doesn't do anything, so we'll need to associate a variable with this check button. So we'll add that as an option. Variable equals, and let's create a variable called x. And we'll need to define this within the window. So after we create our instance of our window, let's say x equals, now with check buttons, they store a 1 or a 0 by default within our variable that we call x. So with x, we're going to set this equal to a int var. If this were to return a string, we would say string var, but normally by default, this returns a 1 or a 0. And we can actually change that using the onvalue and offvalue options. So the onvalue is what's going to be stored within our variable if it's toggled on. So by default, this is 1. And the offvalue is the opposite. This is what is stored within our variable if this is toggled off. All right, now let's have some fun with this. So let's associate a command with this check button. Command equals, and let's create a function called maybe display, and then let's define this before the window, def display, and we're going to check the value of x to see if it's 1 or 0. So within our display function, we're going to check to see if x, and to get the value of x, we're going to use the get function. So if x.get is equal to 1, that means that somebody clicked on the checkbox or toggled it on. So if they check the checkbox or check the check button, then they agree. So print you agree. If it's 0, and we can do this with an else statement, else print you don't agree, frowny face. And let's test this theory. So we have our check button. When we click on this, it's actually going to call our display function. I agree to something, and it says within our console window, you agree. And if I were to toggle this off, it says you don't agree. Let's change the font of our check button. So we'll add that as an option. Font equals, and we can pass in a font that we want. I'll say maybe Arial, and then a size of 20. And now this should be readable. I agree to something. Let's also color this because, well, I like coloring. Let's begin with the foreground color. So that is FG for short. FG equals, and then we can pass in a color name or a hex value. I like hex value, so I'm going to stick with those. I want a green foreground color, so that is 00FF00. But feel free to adjust these values however you want. So our text should now be green. That is a very bright green and it hurts my eyes. So I'm also going to change the background color, which is BG, and I'm going to set this to black. So we'll have green text on a black background. Okay, now when you click on this, it flashes. That's kind of annoying. That's the active foreground and active background. If we click on this or hold this down, the color scheme switches to our active foreground slash background, and we can change those too. So I'm going to set those options. Active foreground, I'm going to set this the same as my foreground color. And the active background will be the same as our normal background. So that's active background equals black. And this should no longer flash when we click on it. Not too bad, not too bad. Let's add some padding. Pad X, I'll set this to 25. And pad Y, I'll set this to 10. We have a little more padding around our check button. One feature that's available to us is that we can add an image next to our check button. I downloaded an image of the Python logo that I want to add. So we'll use the image option to add a photo image to this check button. But first, we need to create a photo image from our image file. So within the window, let's call this Python photo, but you'll probably use something different for your project. Python photo equals photo image. And within the constructor for our photo image, we can set the file path or the file name. Since this image is within my project folder, I only have to list the file name. And this photo of mine is python.png. And now we set the image equal to our photo image that we have. Image equals Python photo. But when we run this, it's going to overlap the text. We still have our image though, and this still works as intended. So in order to display the image as well as the text, we're going to need to use the compound option. And let's add that at the end. Compound is where we're adding this photo relative to the text. I want this photo on the left-hand side of the text, so I'm going to set this to left. And now when we run this, surprise, surprise, our image is on the left-hand side. One thing that you should know is that with the onvalue and the offvalue data type, if you were to change this to a non-integer value, let's say we're going to replace the onvalue with a Boolean value of true, and the offvalue is false. With this variable, make sure to change the data type as well to reflect what you're storing within it. So with our int var variable, we want to change this to a Boolean var value. So replace int with Boolean, and this will work much the same. Now with this display function, we'll need to account for that. So within the if statement here, we'll say if x.get, we don't need to say is equal to 1. This will return true or false, and this will work just the same as it did before. And if you replace this with a string, let's say the onValue is yes, all caps, and the offValue is no. This is now a string var, and we'll change our display function to say if x.get is equal to yes. And this should work. You agree? You don't agree? You agree? You don't agree? And I'll change that back to 1. So 1 and 0 is the default for this, but you can edit these based on what you need. All right, so that's the basics of check buttons in Python. If you want a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of check buttons in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.